Good morning, students. Welcome to the virtual classrooms. In the ionic equilibrium, yesterday in our last lecture, we discussed related to the acid base, the definitions for acid base, which compounds are considered to be as an acid or base. Today we will discuss about the strength of acid base, which is indicated as a strong acid. Or weak acids and base. Now, I am not talking about the concentrated solutions or dilute solutions. The word is different. Here it's a strong acid, strong base, or weak acid, weak base. What does it mean? When you take it as any acid, add it into the water, and if they completely dissociate themselves, they get completely ionized, they produce all the particles of it dissociated into the form of ions. We consider them as strong acid base. Certain acid bases are there which they do not get completely dissociated into ions. Some of them still remain as unreacted. That means they establish the equilibrium in the solution. Then such acid bases are known as weak acid and base. So we define it as strong acids and base as the component when mixed with water, they get one which gets completely dissociated, strong electrolytes or strong acid base, which gets partially, do not get completely dissociated. They are known as weak electrolytes, and weak electrolyte establish an equilibrium in the solution. Now, as per your syllabus, we are discussing it only related to the syllabus, right? Restricted to the syllabus, not to the chemistry, right? In the chemistry, we are having number of strong acids, strong base. But particularly for our syllabus, for 11th standard or 12th standard syllabus, restricted to the chemistry, we consider it strong acids. They are like HCl, HBr, HI, H2SO4, HNO3 or HClO4. For your syllabus, these are only the four that we, for six, we consider them as a strong acids, right? Rest of the acids, we will be considering it as a weak acids. For strong base, LiOH, NaOH, KOH, CaOH twice, SrOH twice, BaOH twice are considered to be as a strong base. Again, I am repeating it. This is only for your syllabus, right? we are having it as a strong acid or strong base. Strong salts or soluble salts are considered to be as a strong electrolytes. That means you can say that the salt formed by HCl LiOH or HBr NaOH or HCl NaOH or HCl plus KOH, right? That is strong acid plus strong base. When they react with one another, they produce a salt. And those salts, when they are formed, they are always strong electrolytes. So salt formed from strong acid, strong base are considered to be as a strong electrolytes, right? So these are what the things that we have to remember: strong acid, strong base. Because rest of the chapter, when we will be going through, every now and then we will be required that they are of a strong acid, strong base. Which are the strong acid, which are the strong base? Every now and then we will be required. So for you will have to remember these six acids and six bases as a strong. Rest of the acids or base, whatever are given, we will be considering them as an weak acids or weak base. Okay. At the same time, we also saw it that we are going to add it into the water. So what will be the behavior of the water? We know it that the water is going to be acting it as an amphoteric component. The amphoteric component means it can react with an acid as well as base. We already saw it in the Lorentz theory that when we were mixing it with acid, it was behaving as a base. When it was mixed with base, it reacted as an acid. So now let's see it, how this water in the normal condition behaves, right? Which is also considered to be as a self-ionization of water, a theory of self-ionization. Now why we wrote it as a self-ionization? Because H2O can act as an acid as well as base, so we will react it as an H2O reacts with H2O. Same water reacts with water. One molecule will act as an acid, another reacts as a base. So on ionization, on reaction, they produce H3O plus and OH minus. According to the Lorentz theory, if this is acid, this produced is H2O donated H plus. So it produces conjugate base. Base, it produces conjugate acid. Alright? So this is a reaction. If I go it for the equilibrium constant, equilibrium means we will be getting it as an H3O plus OH minus upon H2O whole square. But we know it that it's a weak electrolyte. A very small amount of the ionization will be taking place. We can say that almost nearly to a constant, right? So as a result, what we'll say, the change in the concentration of the water is very, very less. Change in concentration of water is very, very less. That concentration of H2O is taken as constant. Therefore, we get it as K equilibrium into H2O, that is equals to H3O plus OH minus. Right? Now, both this we are going to indicate it as a K equilibrium into H2O whole square, we indicate it as KW. This is known as ionization constant of water. Now, that will be indicated as KW equals to H3O plus OH minus. We'll be getting it as in the concentration of H3O plus equals to OH minus in the reaction H3O plus will be equals to
OH minus. Therefore, we get it as KW. That is equals to H3O plus whole square or OH minus whole square. Right. So, from this equation, taking it, the value at 25 degrees Celsius, KW of water is 1 into 10 raised to minus 14. So using this equation, right, if I write it as KW is equals to 1 into 10 raised to minus 14, that is equals to H3O plus whole square or OH minus whole square. So in that case, if I remove the square from both the sides, that means taking square root on both the sides, what will get it? Square root of 1 into 10 raised to minus 14 will be equals to H3O plus or OH minus. We will be getting it H3O plus or OH minus, that equals to 1 into 10 raised to minus 7. We will be getting the value as 1 into 10 raised to minus 7. Now, according to the formula of the pH, if we substitute the value, we are going to get the answer 7. Similarly, pOH, we will be getting it as 7. So, what does it show? That at 25 degrees Celsius, water is neutral. If the temperature changes, then the dissociation changes. So the value of ionization constant of water also changes. So that shows that less than 25 degrees Celsius, water behaves as base. Greater than 25 degrees Celsius, water behaves as acid. So that is particularly at 25 degrees Celsius, it behaves as an acid or a base, right? Depending upon the temperature, it will act. Clear? Okay. Let's go it for the next one. And the next topic, that is a repetition or the revision of your lower standard. That is a pH scale. You already studied in the 10th standard pH scale. That is founded by the scientist named Sorensen, where we can find out the strength of acid or base. Right? So, for pH scale, the scale is of between 0 to 14. At 7, it's a neutral. As we move acidic strength increases, when we move onto the right side, basic strength so that means if I become 0 to 1, 1 to 2, 2 to 3, 3 to 4, that means I am diluting the acid, I am decreasing the concentration of acid. This time I am using the word dilute and concentrated, not strong acid, that we discussed in our initial part of the lecture, right? Here we are talking about the strength. Here it's in related to the concentration. If your concentration of the acid is more, your pH will be more towards the 0. If your concentration of base is more, it will be more towards the 8, dilute towards the 14. That's the difference, right? When the pH increases, basicity of the solution increases, right? Okay, so this is what the pH scale is. the formula we are using for the pH. pH is equals to minus log of H3O plus ion.
It's defined as negative logarithm of the concentration of hydronium ion present in the solution.
pH scale definition defined as negative logarithm of concentration of hydronium ion in the solution.
It's considered to be as a pH.
When I'm writing hydronium, it means it can be indicated as H plus, or you can also write it as H3O plus. Right? Same way, we also calculate it as, for the base, negative logarithm of OH minus. It's considered to be for the base. So, pH plus POH. We are always going to get it as 14. We just saw it in the water. 1 into 10 raised to minus 7. That is for H3O plus. Or OH minus. It was also 1 into 10 raised to minus 7. Therefore, we got it as pH is equals to 7. POH is equals to 7. So, we got it as pH plus POH is equals to 14. And that's the reason why we get it as a pH scale of 0 to 14. But the major limitation of this pH scale is it's applicable only and only for dilute solutions. If the solutions are highly concentrated, then what will happen? It will go out of the range of this scale. And that's the reason why it's not applicable for a concentrated solution. It's applicable only and only for a dilute solutions. Okay. Next, we are having it that is related to, this was the ionization constant for water. Next, we will be studying it, ionization constant of weak acid and weak base. But that will take it in our next lecture. Till then, thank you.